Let us see what happens in this short story, A Letter to God by Gregorio Lopez Fuentes. The only house in the entire valley overlooked a field of ripe corn. Lenko, the owner of the house and field, had been looking at the sky all morning. He told his wife that it was going to rain. Soon, true to Lenko's prediction, big drops of rain began to fall. Lenko went outside to enjoy the rain. He felt that it wasn't rain, but 10 and 5 cent pieces. With satisfaction, he watched the rain shower his ripe corn fields. Suddenly, a strong wind began to blow, and large hailstones began to fall. Lenko's happiness now turned into worry. He hoped that the rain would stop soon, otherwise his crops would be destroyed. But the rain didn't stop. It covered the house, the field, the valley with a layer of white hailstones. The harvest was completely destroyed. Lenko stood in the middle of his ruined field and thought that a plague of locusts would have been better than this. It was a sad night for the Lenko family. However, they had one hope, God. That night, Lenko thought about God and his all-seeing ways. So, he decided to write a letter to God, asking for 100 pesos to sow his field as well as survive until next year. He went to the post office the next day to stamp and mail the letter. The postman, on seeing the letter, laughed and took it to show to his boss, the postmaster. The postmaster, a fat, cheerful man, laughed as well, but he admired Lenko's faith in God. Not wanting to disappoint Lenko, he decided to write an answer. He also realized that he would have to send some money along with the letter. So, he collected contributions from his employees and friends. He also donated a part of his salary. However, he could collect only a little more than half the amount Lenko had asked for. He put the money in an envelope along with a letter marked God. On Sunday, Lenko returned to the post office. The postman handed him the letter. The postmaster, happy with his deed, watched from his office. Lenko was a man of faith, so he wasn't surprised to see the money. However, he was angry when he counted the amount of money. Immediately, he asked for ink and paper. He sat at the writing table and slowly wrote a letter. It looked like he was having trouble expressing his thoughts on paper. Finally, he finished the letter and dropped it in the mailbox. The postmaster immediately collected the letter and opened it. In the letter, Lenko had written that of the 100 pesos, only 70 pesos reached him. He needed 30 pesos more. But he asked God not to send it to the post office. He believed the people at the post office were thieves who stole his 30 pesos.